Hello, my name is Dionysios Karidis. I am a PhD student at the Aristotle University of Thessaloniki, Greece. My PhD thesis is about the calculation of periodic orbits in complex gravitational fields using both heuristic and traditional methods. With this study, we expect to find periodic orbits and their families in severely disturbed gravitational systems, such as the two or the three-body problem, using bodies of a random mass distribution. The search for periodic orbits can be utilized using heuristic algorithms based on evolutionary techniques. Furthermore, other minimization methods have been used that simulate natural processes without necessarily knowing the dynamics of the system that is being analyzed. Such a method is the particle swarm optimization, which is based upon the way in which a flock of birds flies in synchronization with each other. A second way would be by using analytic methods on a simple geometric object and then implementing a shape continuation technique to simulate eventually the dynamics of a more complex body. The advantages of the first method are the following. First of all, it is not necessary that we know the dynamic characteristics of the gravitational field of any object beforehand. Secondly, the speed of the search process compared with other classic methods is by far higher. Furthermore, we can easily discover unusual orbits that would have been almost impossible to find using other conventional methods. The main disadvantage of the first method is that the accuracy of the solutions is usually insufficient, and therefore a complementary method is required in order to achieve the desired precision of the initial conditions that determine the periodic orbit. Such a method could be the differential corrections approach. The advantages of the second method, that is the one using analytic methods and then implementing continuation of the orbits, are the following. Starting with a simple geometric object, we can find periodic orbits and their families relatively easy and fast. The use of classical theorems is possible, as well as the analytic study of the dynamics. Due to the intrinsic symmetries, calculations may be simply fight since it is possible to reduce the number of the system's free variables. This can result in a significant reduction of the computational cost. A disadvantage of the second method is that the orbit of a simple symmetric object could only be used as a rough estimation of the corresponding orbit of a real asymmetric asteroid. These initial estimation orbits are usually not accurate near the asteroid surface and could only be used efficiently in an adequate distance from it. Therefore, it is necessary to adjust the orbit of the basic model to that of the asteroids using a shape continuation process that we propose in the following sections. We have created a method of modeling any 3D object using mass cones, which are in fact point masses that help us simulate its gravitational field by simply adding the individual fields exerted by all the discrete masses. In addition, a method of transforming an ellipsoid consisting of mass cones into the shape of any desired asteroid has been implemented too. That enables us to use a continuation process in order to start from a known orbit of a certain ellipsoid and end up with a new equivalent orbit for the asteroid. In that way, we have obtained many families of periodic orbits of Eros, which was chosen among others because it is a highly non-symmetric and irregular object. The simple model used is a uniformly rotating triaxial ellipsoid, which serves as a starting point before simulating the shape of any other real asteroid with an elongated oval shape. In order to create the computational space needed, a grid of a certain resolution is created that has the dimensions of the desired ellipsoid. Same principles apply for modeling error. Since no symmetries exist here, a ray casting method was used to create the mass cones. Two files provided by NASA were used in order to check whether each cell of the computational grid lies within or out of the real surface of Eros, the one containing the vertices and the other the indices that define the surface of the real asteroid. The grid resolution that was chosen is the best compromise between computational cost and model's accuracy. This leads almost to 4,600 mascons for the model of errors and to 4,300 mascons for the ellipsoid. While modeling errors, we set the type of each cell to one of three values that signify whether a mascon belongs first to both the ellipsoid and errors, secondly, only to the asteroid, finally, only to the ellipsoid. The next thing we need to do is to equate the principal moments of inertia for both objects. In order for the ellipsoid and the asteroid to have the same angular momentum, the dimensions or semi-axis A, B, and C of the first object should be set on specific values. In cases like strongly asymmetric asteroids, where the gravitational potential has no symmetries at all, we expect the periodic orbits to be asymmetric and three-dimensional. The periodicity conditions that should hold are that after a full period, the position and velocity vectors should be exactly the same. Because of the existence of the Jacobian integral, and since we are using a Poincaré section, the free variables can be reduced from 6 to 4. An alternative way of obtaining periodic orbits is by using Poincaré maps for many different levels of energy and observing the islands of the invariant curves of the phase space. Let's follow the first method of shape continuation of periodic orbits that uses a set of intermediate models. This means that we create multiple models that gradually transform the shape of the ellipsoid into that of Eros. In order to avoid jumps to other families during the continuation process, we change only a small number of mascons in each step. Initially, a genetic algorithm was used for the continuation due to its resilience to the asymmetries and its adaptability to unknown conditions. Nevertheless, in order to increase the precision of the results, we chose a more precise method, that of the differential corrections. The addition and subtraction of the necessary mascons was done in a sequential way. This operation is done from the front side of the asteroid backwards. Unfortunately, sometimes we noticed some rather steep changes in the four variables that were adjusted throughout the continuation. In our second approach, however, the addition and subtraction of the mascons was done in a completely random way, but even so, the steep changes were not completely eradicated. It should be noted, though, that this behavior didn't have any functional consequences on the results. In these figures, we can see five intermediate steps of the transformation of the model itself and the according adjustment of the orbits while using the discrete shape continuation. In the six plots shown here, we see the visualization of the transition of the four variables that change throughout the process and the corresponding changes of energy and period. The shape continuation is done in a discrete and sequential way for an orbit of multiplicity 2 and in 94 steps. This is a similar figure showing a transition for an orbit of multiplicity 3, and for the same continuation, the transition of variables is shown at the multiple plot figure. The steps used here were only 32. We can move on now to the second method, that of the analytic shape continuation. Using the function depicted here, we calculate the theoretical number of mascons that contribute in each step of the continuation. This way, we are able to distribute the total mass to the number of mascons that take part in each step. We see clearly how smooth an analytic shape continuation is for an orbit of multiplicity 2 that took place in 41 steps. Another example is shown here for a higher multiplicity orbit. And we will start now by studying some of the periodic orbit families of the triaxial ellipsoid. Since all previous work was mostly focused on studying planar periodic orbits, we have extended the search for three-dimensional ones. In addition, our approach of finding these orbits was not only based on purely computational methods, but mainly on studying the vertical stability index along a family of planar periodic orbits from which bifurcations occur. These bifurcations arise at certain points of the family where the vertical stability index crosses the values of plus or minus 2. The figure shows the vertical stability index of the circular, planar, retrograde, and prograde periodic orbit of the ellipsoid for the first three multiplicities. We can see here the interconnections between four families of the ellipsoid that form bridges between the prograde and the retrograde planar circular. Other families end up in one of the equilibrium points, though. Four other families of the ellipsoid are depicted here, as well as their relations to each other. We will now present some families of periodic orbits of Eros, beginning with the smallest multiplicity. And for a retrograde kind of movement, we can see that almost everywhere the family is fully stable. The shape continuation that was applied here was analytic, and only 21 steps were used. For the same family, we can see the two ways of the discrete shape continuation, the one with the sequential change of mass cones in the intermediate models and the other with a fully random change. It is evident that the final orbits that all three methods converged into are identical. This clearly proves the correctness of those methods. Another example is shown here of KO2 family of Eros with a multiplicity of 2, as we can see from the two sample orbits. The two planar families of the ellipsoid, the prograde and the retrograde one, are depicted as well. The positive part of the symmetric family of the ellipsoid from which the continuation started is also shown here. We can see how asymmetric and overly winding the family of Eros is. In order to follow the curve of the symmetric family of the ellipsoid as much as possible, we tried to start the continuation from other member orbits as well. This gave rise to more families that do follow the symmetric family very well, except for some minor parts of it. Starting from an even higher multiplicity, here it is 3, we have family L13 of Eros. We see that both the analytic and the discrete kind of shape continuation performed well. The first and the last orbit of this process are both shown here. Three sample orbits are presented here. And we will continue by giving some examples of some mainly prograde families. Starting with the almost planar circular one, we can see that this family is almost everywhere stable except when approaching the asteroid. The analytic continuation performed very smoothly and in just 21 steps. Stepping up the multiplicity to 2 now, we have a similar family that is mainly planar but forms an interesting S-like shape where the orbits become three-dimensional. Notice that the same cusp appears here too. We study here the stability of the family roughly and then more precisely using Poincaré maps. And there would be no actual point in continuing the search for periodic orbits since they are literally countless. So we conclude with the advantages of our method. First of all, everything that was implemented to Eros could be directly applied to any other asteroid as well. Should the same work be applied to more symmetric bodies, such as Apophis and many others, the results would be faster, easier, and more predictable. The benefits of setting a space device in a certain well-known a priori orbit instead of using thrusters all the time are pretty obvious. Apart from saving fuels, we can calculate in advance stable orbits for studying, photographing, and for synchronous movement, and unstable ones for landing. Since we have prepared all the families for each type of orbit, we can choose how close to or how far from the object we want to be. Furthermore, we can choose what level of velocity is needed for any kind of measurements that are needed to be taken. We can also choose from retrograde or direct orbits. Our next goal is to apply our knowledge to a double asteroid system. An excellent example is along with its moon Dimorphos. Thank you all. If there are any questions, I would be glad to answer.
Thank you. Are there any questions for Mr. Karidis?